If you pay attention to other matters than Krishna consciousness, then fear will arise. By being away from Krishna consciousness, the fear creeps in. By the influence of Maya, an opposite frame of mind develops. Therefore, a pandit, a learned person, an intelligent man, therefore an intelligent man will surrender to spiritual master with unalloyed devotion and start the bhajan of Parameshwara. Ananya means sometimes this demigod, sometimes this demigoddess, not like this. Why? Because out of fear one approaches many demigods and goddesses. Sometimes one may think that this is my family guru and this is this and this is this. There will be no benefit out of this. One must approach a spiritual master. Intelligent person would approach a spiritual master and start Hari Bhajan immediately. Therefore, Guru must be considered as Devata, demigod, or and Atma. Atma Swarup, Super Soul. One's very dear. One must accept spiritual master as his very dear person and start Hari Bhajan. If the yogis do not perform devotional service, their yogis and jnanis will never attain perfection if they do not do any devotional service. But if one leaves all these processes and does Hari Bhajan, proper unalloyed devotional service, he will be able to satisfy Supreme Lord, not contaminated by the karma, jnana and yoga. The fruitive work, the speculative knowledge and the mystic yoga. Free from all these three, one must engage in Hari Bhakti. When Vasudev inquired in Dwarka, Narad Goswami illustrated the Bhagavad Dharma like this. In the Nemin of Yogindra context, it was mentioned here. This verse was mentioned in the context. Rishabhadev had 100 children. There was one Mahabhagavat. 9 were the leaders of Navadvip, 9 islands. Maharaj is naming these Navagindras. And it is, this verse is from the same context. Why the fear creeps in, it is mentioned herein. This is only known and understood by the grace of a sadhu. One gets to know that, and again reaches, again approaches Krishna, then he will obtain him. Why again, why is it said again? Because had he had initially in the very beginning chosen, when he was in the tatastha mode, he had chosen to enjoy in the material world. So now again is mentioned. By the if when the grace of sadhu, shastra and guru comes, the same living entity will be freed from maya. Maya will leave that person, that living entity. Evidence was given from Bhagavad Gita that Maya is very difficult to surpass, but one who surrenders unto me will be freed from the clutches. Arjun had mentioned initially in Bhagavad Gita then Krishna replied, he said, definitely there is no doubt in this, but O mighty armed Arjun, you are a mighty armed Arjun, you are very powerful. Mind is definitely very difficult to control. The ways of mind are very difficult to control, but only by practice and detachment one can control mind. What is practice? If you practice a procedure time and again and again, and what is vairagya? Detachment from worldly affairs and attachment towards the other field is vairagya. Just as a worm,
just as a worm, he is when he has to go from one leaf to another leaf, then what he does, that first he catch hold of the first leaf properly and then leaves the one which he was holding earlier. So in the same way, a living entity, when he attains the higher place first, and then he leaves the another one, otherwise he never leaves.
Therefore it is mentioned in one verse that I have obeyed the orders of lust, greed, etc. I have obeyed the orders of them for such a long time. I have become a servant. Even then, they did not leave me. They did not have mercy upon me. But I was such a shameless person. I was such a shameless person that I did not attain peace at all. O Krishna, now I have come to your shelter. You kindly accept me as one of your servants. I was I was originally, the constitutional position was of that of a servant. Now you kindly redesignate me as your servant, as one of your servants. In the prayers of Brahma, in the 10th canto of 10th canto 14th chapter of Bhagavat, that went through their own sensual endeavors, one tries to obtain Krishna, then when they throw their own endeavors, they give up their own sensual endeavors to obtain God and go and approach here from a bona fide sadhu, then they become eligible to be liberated and they also get the designation of the servant of Krishna back. They will attain liberation and also be redesignated to their position of the servant, the original constitutional position of a servant of Krishna back. So he will become eligible when he comes into the shelter where he surrenders. He will definitely be liberated. Vishwanatha Chakurthi said, he will surely be liberated. He will get the designation as well, the post as well. He will go ahead from where he has reached. He will not have to perform Hari Bhakti again from the beginning. He will start from where he had left. Why? Because he had reached his designation back. He has got his designation back. This happens only by the grace of sadhu and sastra. It is not sure that it will surely happen. Only the deserving candidates will get the real grace of sadhu, shastra and guru. If a feast is organized, then if someone has a disease, then can the same person eat everything? Why? Because he is suffering from a disease. Similarly, not everyone can become Krishna consciousness, conscious. If one becomes Krishna conscious, then the Maya will leave him, the illusionary energy will leave him, will not bother him anymore. But when Lord mentions that Mame Mahaprapadyate, then why is it necessary to approach a sadhu? Maharaj is saying that the real surrender is surrendering to a sadhu. One may go to Bhagwan and may offer prayers that I am a sinner, I have been born out of sins, I am doing sinful deeds, I have been born out of sins. They show their humility before Bhagwan. Then the Mahatma saw, one Mahatma saw the person offering these kind of prayers. Then he called him, "Oh sinner, you come here, I want to speak to you." The person immediately got furious and wanted to hit. He says, you're calling me by these sinful names? And he started abusing the Mahatma. That why are you calling me sinners? Mahatma says, I am not saying anything on my own. You were just offering prayers to Krishna, prayer to Bhagavan a moment ago, that you are a sinner, you are born out of sins, you have sinful deeds, etc. You yourself named yourself as a sinner. What is the wrong that I have committed by calling you a sinful person? You had mentioned so many adjectives to yourself. I only named one. Now what will that person who is offering prayers like this say? Similarly, if we go and show our humility before Krishna, that humility is not actual humility. We must go and surrender to a sadhu. Why? Because it is mentioned in Brahmaji's prayers that we must go to a place where satsang is organized and serve him through our mind, words and body. And the sadhu will cut all your material entanglements by his Vedic injunctions and will free you from the clutches of Maya. There was a person who used to sing nice kirtan. Like he used to say, he used to speak the opposite thing of what was actually written in the kirtan. He is calling Bhagavan as Tumi to Thakur. But when Sant Maharaj was standing on the first floor and immediately slapped him and came on the ground floor and told him that why has Lord given you eyes? Can't you read it properly from the book and then sing? He was a wonderful kirtaniya, but did not pay any attention to the words written in the book, in the Gita. So, by the grace of sadhu, first by the grace of gadhu, sadhu will catch your hypocrisy. By reading scriptures it will not happen, but the whatever is mentioned in the granth, the scriptures, if it that same text, that same words emanate from the mouth of a bona fide sadhu, then those words will have great effect. Then one can conquer what is unconquerable. Sukhdev was in the womb of mother. He was there for many long years. For about 16 long years he was in the womb of mother, and he used to answer from within the womb. Vyasadeva asked who big personality, exalted personality, Mahatma is inside the womb. Sukhdev said, I will not go in the region of Maya illusion. Maya will influence me. Vyas Dev said that I promise that Maya will not have an effect on me. Sukhdev said that I will not come out from with your promise, just by your promise. But I will come out only if the master of the illusory energy promises me. Then,